holding your baby up in the air saying, let's make money.
Yeah.
I mean, aren't you just instilling a sort of ruthless, horrible commercial streak in this boy?
No, not... You know what? Everything I'm doing is all in good intentions behind it. Like, growing up, I didn't have a good life. You know, my mum was a single mum of five and she struggled, we struggled, and I didn't get to do the things that my friends were doing and things. And everything I'm doing, Piers, is for her. I just want her to have...
Well, it's about you as well, isn't it?
Not really. It's about her. If you asked me before I had winter, I'd be like, yeah, it's about me. But everything I'm doing is for her. Every bit of money we make goes into her savings.
We're just seeing winter now in our green room this morning. Sally, you have a problem, don't you, with having an Instagram account for a two-year-old and exposing them to this much publicity so young?
This child is absolutely enchanting. She's gorgeous, but it's her life. Lateysha has already done very well in reality TV. This little girl should be out there getting filthy, dirty, catching
nudes. But she does. She has a normal two-year-old life. But
the absolute focus...
It's not a normal life.
You're living it online. Focus on appearance. It's this business of always focusing on appearance, having endless shoots. You look at this poor little... the Kardashian child, the first thing that little girl ever said was no pictures, aged about 18 months.
But everything's in good intentions. I think the Beckhams are a bit different, you know, like they've come from money. But, you know, I just want to give her the best life I can.
What I worry about is I think that, you know, social media does have a place and some people find it very positive. It can be a very negative place and people can make very nasty comments.
Yeah, of course, that's a downside to it.
Yeah,
of course,
You know, children aren't supposed to be on, you know, having these accounts until they're 13, although I'm not sure how on earth that's policed. Mm. Do you not worry about a backlash against winter? And also that she'll just become a little bit obsessed with image and what she looks like online rather than living her life.
You know, she knows her values and everything. I'll never let her become one of those airheads. And, yeah, I do worry about the trolls. That's one thing I do worry about, but, you know.
Do you?
But why do?
Do you worry about the trolls?
Yeah,
when you put your kid at that age all over social media every minute of the day.
Who controls that beautiful two-year-old child? Do you know what I mean?
Well, no, absolutely no one should.
But why?
And there are horrible people out there who...
But you know there are trolls out there and you're feeding the possibility they're just going to target you, as they do.
Yeah, I know. There's downsides to it and I agree with that. But like I said, I'm just trying to, you know, give her a good life.
How much money do you make from her?
You'll have to wait and find out and watch the show.
$1 million baby.
How much are we talking about?
Well, hoping to make a million, presumably.
What do you get for an Instagram post of your little kid?
It varies.
But like what?
I don't know, it varies.
You can
earn up to £1,000 from an Instagram post.
So you put a picture of your little child on Instagram, get £1,000. But you cut away any right she has to any privacy, right?
Yeah, but I'm sure she won't be complaining when she's older and she can go to the university when she wants to go to.
But why on earth shouldn't she have the choice to make up her own mind when she gets to 15, 16, 17, rather than having it foist onto her at the age of two?
Except that argument applies to every single person who puts a picture of their child on Facebook.
But this is specifically to monetize a little child who ought to be out there.
But I'm not doing a bad thing. I'm making money for her future.
But
do you know what I mean?
But there's an absolute epidemic of mental health problems for little girls. They're very aware of their appearance.
If I ever felt like it was affecting her mental health, I would put a complete
stop.
She's such a happy child. Like, everyone that meets her says she's so happy, she's so content.
But wait till she gets trolled. Wait till she has the misery of suddenly turning into a plump nine-year-old and everybody really going after her because she's been this little superstar.
She is a superstar and she's absolutely gorgeous. It's great to see her in the green room. I think that a lot of people will have, unfortunately, an issue with, sort of the monetization.
Yeah.
But, you know, you're only doing, as we say, what the Kardashians and the Beckhams do.
Yeah, but, you know, I have better intentions than them.
Do you?
They've come from money, Piers.
They haven't come from money. Neither of them had any money when they were young. Mm.
They're millionaires.
They came into money and now they're exploiting their brand through their kids, which I find equally unedifying.
It's what a lot of people do.
I don't think there's much difference between what you're doing than
the 21st century.
Yeah. Lateysha, thanks very much indeed. Yeah. Sally, thanks for coming in to talk about it. and thanks very much to Winter, who is a, you know, she is a superstar.
She's beautiful.
No doubt about it. Stay just as you are, Winter.